Yeah, I know. I'm OD Pixel. I'm here with Fog. We have some spectacular Dota 2 coming your way.
Well, that's when we see the ETs. You really start to go out of control in the laning phase when you get that extra damage from your spirit as Nisha.
Yeah, bottom puppy did have to leave Nisha for a bit. He's heading to the jungle, and that will leave Nisha vulnerable enough for Alliance to claim the kill and get first blood. This time the combo was there. We start to really see the strength of the heroes tested. Bottom lane, another attempt onto puppy. He's able to turn and get the dual breath off, but Boxy's on top of him.
A lot of damage.
Turn, get another fire blast out. We'll be able to get the kill and separate himself from Nisha. Nisha now getting stunned up. In fact, Boxy, he's ready to go back in.
He's got Arcane.
Puppy's dead for five. They've got mana to go, but Alliance chasing down the Arc Warden. Nisha getting clobbered by Boxy as he slaps him down. They'll get both Alliance on this bottom lane. Tiger should fall for the efforts, but definitely a worthy play there from Alliance, getting both kills.
Super mid one, being able to get that.
See Absol going for the wraparound. This time, as you say, he's going to be here to help out. But same thing to be said for Alliance. They've brought Insania in straight away. They've taken Nisha out of the lane. Yapzor goes for the stomp. He's not going to hit anyone. They're able to easily kite it out.
Try to defend. He hides in the tree line. He's TPing bottom.
Let's have a look. See if I can slow this one down. He's going to look for the setup onto Boxy. Boxy's a tanky ogre, though. And Quokka's already surrounding him. Puppy behind the tower. Now he'll turn back towards Zai. Zai getting nuked down. Zai's going to throw the boat out. Zai, he's in a lot of trouble. We'll get the roam upon him, but with the purifying flames, Zai's just straight up dead. They'll turn towards Puppy as well. The multicast is out. Quokka with the double kill will die as he does sort of hang around in the macro pyre a little too long. Time that he's been off the map in this early stages. We're going to see Quokka. He's going to have a little bit of a look into try for the 15-minute rune, but Secret, they've got the numbers here. Get the ice path down onto Quokka. Quokka's got the backup of Insania. They'll turn for the rune. Mikkei jumps in with a combo. He looks to burst down Zai. He's got it. Zai's dead. There's the false promise. Keep it Quokka alive. Stomps out from Yapzor. Buyback as well from Zai. They'll run down Mikkei. Mikkei's taken out Quokka. He's going to take a fair bit of damage. Will be able to heal back up. Can Insania save him? The fear comes in. Tiger with the save. Keeping Quokka fine. Sending all four members back from Secret. Very good at keeping an advantage and not making, you know, the questionable plays.
Zai.
See Zai. He's been found. Easy pick off for Alliance. So now, Nisha did just send in the Tempest double. Certainly worth easily killing as well.
Easy 240 for Mikkei.
But yeah, you have to watch out for any mistakes now if you're Alliance. As I say, they don't make mistakes. This is a refined team that is very good at closing up a one game.
Mikkei, again.
He's in with the jump. He's been able to toss him back. He's on top of Nisha. Nisha's dead again.
He's dead. They just got Nisha like that. He stepped up way too far.
He's having a rough game. That pressure in the lane.
Oh, Puppy almost goes down to the trees.
As they're just pushing in, they're onto the high ground. Alliance, they know exactly what they need to do this game.
This is their timing to end it. As mid one, he goes in, he gives a poke. He has a BKB on now too, but are available as well. But he's going to have to commit it here to charge Sloan, and they've already lost their melee rounds.
See what mid one can do. He's going to pop the BKB. He's trying to get on top of Quokka. They'll get the stomp out, but Quokka's on the back of Insania. Quokka getting trapped back by the X-Man. The boat's down. But the
old Sweater
does catch the four of them. It's a big one. Allows Yapsa to run in. Slap down Insania. Insania is dead. Jump back in from Mikkei, though. Comes in with a combo. Puppy lines down the ice path to block off Quokka from Mikkei. Tiger's on the high ground. Another fire blast down onto Yapsa. They'll turn towards Tiger.
Nisha's back.
Get him out. They'll get the two of them. Alliance, can they get the rest of them out safely? Nisha's going to have the Tempest double in place to spot out Mikkei. Mikkei goes straight for the TP out, not able to cancel in time.
And look at this, immediately they're already starting to push that top lane.
Mid-1
just goes for the racks, and they don't have TPs available. And he gets it.
Okay, so this is how potentially Alliance could lose the game. Bottom lane, range racks down.
Can he catch him? He gets the toss back here, but there's a BKB available. Mid-1 is top of pressure.
So we've got the combo out, straight away onto Quokka, but Insania's there, and he has got False Promise if it's needed. He's going to hold on to the last minute, of course, doesn't want to use it too prematurely. That'll be the buyback from Puppy. Focusing their efforts immediately onto Zai. Can they burst him down or get another X mark out? But they've got the Crypt Swap. Zai's out, another buyback from Secret.
Quokka
will fall. They get the stomp out, the combo's there from Yapsa. He lines it up perfectly. Insania's beat down. The rest of Alliance, can they retreat? Mikkei's going to turn, start tossing the trees out. Won't be enough to kill off Nisha. Nisha's able to stay alive. Boxy's being focused. Mid one with the BKBs on top of the Ogre. Tiger's trying to hide in the trees. But Secret, they found them as well. As this time, Alliance will not be getting out alive. Weird mystical orb. New items, you know, new items confirmed.
The push with this level 3 exorcism. You see, mid one, he's trying to push out that mid lane as far as possible, but Mikkei's there with response and he has the bots.
See how Alliance can get away with this. That's done. Finish off the tier 3 tower, quite for now, focusing towards the racks. Boxy gets the good multicast out onto Puppy. Puppy He's in trouble, and he's dead. The Ghost will finish him off. They get the Jakira, and that is, of course, Puppy dead for a long time after that buyback on the last events. Quakefer now false promised. Insania trying to keep him safe. Uyul's up to dodge the boat. Midone trying to focus down onto Insania. We'll get it. Insania's dead. Midone's BKB wears off as he'll now back away himself. Quakefer's BKB is up and ready to go. They turn the Curse Crown, the Fire Blast. They've got the focus. Zai, he's dead without buyback as well. So is Yapsa. Three dead on Secret with no way back into the game. Nisha's in trouble.
Oh,
Elytra on top of the Nisha's dead for 50. He has got buyback. But still three members that do not. Midone getting tossed up in the trees by Mikkei. Alliance. In this game one,
he's just forced to buy back when his timer is pretty low just to try to stop this mega creep pushing.
Alliance able to make sure the Secret don't get the opportunity to grab that Aegis, at least for now.
They're trying to do the poke thing onto Quakefer, but there's that Oracle just constantly throwing those heals.
Look at this horse back here. Mikkei's able to get in, grab Zai. Zai's up on top of Boxy, and Zai's dead.
No Zai.
Another catch successfully performed by Mikkei. It's Nisha. He's going to send the double. Insania, quick reactions there as he instantly false promises himself. Quakefer will move in, take out the Tempest double. Puppy laying down the Macro Pyre. They've put the combo as well onto Insania, but Insania's still alive. Quakefer using up to be able to burn down Puppy with the Ghost. Puppy's dead. Midone tries to go towards Quakefer with the BKB, but the multicast come out. Boxy's got the control. Quakefer finally falls. Boxy turns. He's turning for more. He's trying to control Midone, but Midone's already cleaned up. Mikkei's dead for 107. There'll be buybacks coming out from both Quakefer and Insania. But Midone was able to get the big kills there, the big cleanup, as the Spider did prove to be too much in that fight for Alliance to deal with. And find Quakefer, able to get himself into the shadows quickly. Midone. To avoid the... No, he's going to look to turn around and help out. Realize that Boxy's pretty isolated, but Boxy does have the BKB. Starts to get the multicast out onto Midone.
Quakefer's zoning them away here with this exorcism.
They are split up apart here. Midone, he's trying to go for the backliners, and he's found. He's able to get him with the Hex onto Insania. That is Insania dead for 70 without the buyback. He'll now sweep back over to help the rest of his team. He's looking towards Quakefer. Quakefer's got the BKB popped. He'll leave Quakefer alone for now. But still some good right click being done by Nisha with the Tempest double. Zai continuing to juke him out. Zai finally falls. They get the Kunkka, but Zai has buyback. He'll buyback straight away. Midone, he can look to try and punish these vulnerable targets now that the BKBs have worn off on the course, particularly Quakefer. Quakefer will have the Ghost Heal coming in soon. Is it going to be enough to keep him safe? Yapsol with the slaps. The BKB on the other side. He's able to finish him off. Another Hex from Midone. He's able to lock down a second. Boxy's dead as well. They turn towards Mikkei. Mikkei tries to over the trees, but Midone jukes it out. Back in
oh
he goes.
God.
Godlike with the double kill. Midone getting the kills and playing the fight perfectly. Tiger is also going to die as Secret get the triple kill. Midone.
Oh.
He really did it there. You saw, you know, he let the rest of his team go to work. He was like, right, boys, I'm finding that.
Dude.
I'm finding that Oracle.
Nisha didn't get hit once in that entire fight in the river. He literally just was sitting there casting everything. Look, 12 Sparklers, 5 Magnetic Fields.
They have got their buybacks.
Oh, my
God. And they are going to need to use them, Alliance. As the mid lane's getting poked at, Boxy. He's going to try and commit. Pops the BKB.
They're just taking down the towers. They have to buy back on
everybody. You've got to buy back on everyone. This is Secret going for the GG push here. Straight away, they'll turn towards Yapsa. Yapsa getting stunned up the Avalanche as well. Yapsa's dead.
Secret just trying to bail here now as they force every single buyback.
They've got to try and catch more here. See if they can find Zai. Zai. He's able to juke it out into the trees, trying for the TP, but Boxy's got the vision. They'll stun him up, and Midone, he's going to come over and start to help maybe. Boxy has not got the BKB, but indeed the Curse Crown is going to hit the two of them. Midone, he walked into it, but he has the BKB. Goes into the trees, BKB, TP out, will keep himself. Zai, of course, still alive. Finally, Mikkei will jump in to clean him up. Zai now the one to be dead. He's got 8,000 gold. I mean, at the least, right, you're in the base. You buy the recipe for the Ags, you swallow it up as the Brood, and you pick yourself another item, right?
He's just saving for the buyback. That's probably the
but he's got
main
enough.
Thing that's focused on his head, though,
he's
right?
Got surely, you're in base, upgrade the Ags, buy yourself a sick fight. He's got 8,000 gold. You got to spend it, right?
It's chaos at the moment.
It is chaos. At the moment, it's with his teams as Alliance. Hard committing here to try and finish off this final set of racks in the middle lane. And they'll get it. They'll get the melee. They'll turn towards the range with the Ghost still out. Puppy's going to leave four. Curse Crown's out. Boxy pops the BKB. They'll get the final Rex. They'll get the Mega Creeps. Now they've got to make sure that they don't have any casualties. Jump in. Tiger. He's on top of Midone. Midone slides to the side. Midone's dead. They'll get the kill. There's the buyback from the Spider. Midone straight back in. See if they can chase down these kills in Alliance. Tiger has fallen. Alliance, they may have got Megas, but they cannot afford to die. They don't have buybacks. Quakefer's gone. They're chasing for more. Secret. They've found Insania. Insania's hexed up. They may have got the Megas, but that's two heroes dead for over 80 seconds.
You see the Desolator bought by Nisha. They're ready. They're ready to push.
Buy an Necrobook mid one. Get someone else for the push.
He's got to buy something. Look at this, Nisha. With that Deso, they're looking to end it too.
I mean, they know.
It's not available.
This dude, Secret's got it, right?
They got to put a lot of pressure on.
Where's the creeps at?
Mickey's looking to just keep cutting them here. He walks behind that mid creep wave, and he does that to get it. But the damage is coming through. It's too
they've
much.
They've got it. They've got it. Secret has got it.
God.
It's over.
Holy.
So as we're saying, Outrun, easy game for Secret. As we said, Alliance, a fight they put up.
And game one of TI9 group stages has technically a mega creep comeback.
Oh, it was.
Right?
No, absolutely.
It's technically a mega creep comeback.
In the mid lane as a gyro, with your base damage, you're not going to get to hit a lot of creeps, right?
Yeah.
Against, if it is going to be the lone druid going mid, which you would imagine. But we'll see. We'll see how Onish can do it. Already, Puppy.
He's looking dead.
It's been found out. Tiger's able to trap him with the brambles, and that's first blood for Boxy.
But still pretty strong tri lane here coming out from Alliance. So it's a little bit weird.
A bit of a go onto Mickey with the cold snap.
He managed
to land the torrent. I'll bring a hit too, and Mickey.
They actually get him with that. Wow. They have to connect that torrent there in order to get that kill.
Yeah, they had to hit everything, and they did Secret. Bring a root off, but Nisha, he's got enough stats to sort of hold his ground, and then deep with his wraparound from Zai. Quaifa in a whole world of trouble. Dunk down from Zai, and Quaifa's punished for trying to poke at the gyrocopter.
He's going to be problematic. Yeah, they have the Axe versus the Troll is the other matchup they do have. So Troll, you have Battle Trance. If Axe gets a good start off, he's always going to be able to get those successful dunks.
Trance to control the Cold Snap and the Rocket Barrage.
Ooh.
Tornado up the air. It wasn't quite the combo with the missile, but it gets the kill.
They have level 6. They're not level 6 on Taiga still. The Willow's still not quite there.
One kill will do it, though.
One kill will do
it. You got a kill to start things up. Well, one kill is going to be a CM, and it is. There you go. One kill does it. Tiger's now hit level 6. There's the fear straight out to two of them. They're moving the combo. The sun rays out as well. Mikkel on the mana. They cut the shrine to fight around them. Boxy trying to head towards it, but the pull from the Berserker's Call grabs him away. They'll turn towards the sun. Secret, they'll kill off Insaner as well. A buyback coming out from Boxy. He wants to get stuck back in and help out the team, and it will allow them to get mid one. They should have a good chance of getting Nisha as well, actually, with that play. And straight away, first hit root from Quaifa comes in. Alliance will be able to overall punish Secret for those deep kills.
Gotta get that Radiant, and he's not really that close to it still.
Well, he might be as close to the TP he can. Finds Quaifa trying to TP out in the trees. Quaifa is dead.
But he's still a ways away.
Trying to do all they can to slow this down. Again, Zai is able to jump in.
That was real close for Insania.
Just getting out with that dive in time. Looked like that call almost caught him.
Okay, he is positioned here to go for some of the wraparound. Zai still full HP though.
Okay. Just be careful how he pokes. Of course, without that BKB, Nisha now starting to move it towards the pair. Zai's able to get in the backline, able to actually dunk down Insania. Now he turns as well towards Mikke. Mikke is in trouble, he's out of mana, he's out of health. That's Mikke dead too. A buyback comes out from Insania. A Secret again, just getting kill after kill.
They tried to get a wraparound there to protect, but Yapzor actually got the Spirit Vessel onto Boxy before he got a blink off, so he was interrupted the whole fight there.
And now Zai's not only got a full Crimson Guard, he's got a full pipe as well. Zai jumping in onto Boxy.
So damage.
Koifa's trying to hit back with the bear, but this 21 minutes pipe Crimson Act is almost impossible for Alliance to deal with. They just run down Boxy. Boxy has to buy back. The Rack's in the middle lane in trouble. A Secret 11k lead. The egg comes out. Secret will look to try and take it down. They can't quite get it in time. They're being forced back. The Supernova successful. They pop the Aegis on Nisha. Now the Sunray down. They're burning mid one. They're burning Zai. A Tornado comes out from Yapzor to hold back the lines. Secret still all stay alive. Now they can go back in. Zai jumps in with the call onto Quaifa. Quaifa's dead. Mikke falls as well. Boxy's surrounded. EMP's out. Four dead on Alliance. GG is called. And Secret will take game two. 21 minutes in, 15k lead, and this is, I think, sort of the type of game Secret themselves expected to play coming into TI.
Yeah, this was a ridiculous display, actually. The Invoker ended up working out perfectly.